Hello learners, welcome to the English language teaching program for undergraduates presented by Maulana Azad National Urdu University. We'll be learning today about the use of English verbs in their various tenses and forms. English verbs have been categorized as main verbs, auxiliaries and modals. We'll confine our study today to the learning of the use of simple present tense, present continuous tense and present tense used in future aspect. So let us make a beginning with the use of learning of simple present tense. Simple present tense is used to express habitual action, action taking place at the present time but not continuing. It is also used for routine action or for states of being. So let me give an example to you of simple present tense being used for habitual action. I go for a walk every day. Now here we are talking about something that one does daily. I take a cup of coffee in the morning. Again here we are talking about an action which takes place every day. Simple present tense is also used for an action that is planned for future. Let me give an example. India meets West Indies tomorrow. Again, simple present tense for future action like I will see you tomorrow when I come back. Here, in the second part of the sentence, I have made use of simple present tense to express future time. Here we are talking about something that is going to take place in future, but we are using simple present tense. He seems to be very happy today. We are talking here of a state of being, somebody being happy. Now from simple present tense, let us move to continuous tense, present continuous tense. Now if you learn simple present tense in relation to present continuous tense, it will help us in erasing some of the confusions, misconceptions about the use of these two tenses. Sometimes we use simple present where we should use present continuous, or we use present continuous where you should use present simple. Now the reason is, in both the cases we are talking about some action in the present, but present continuous tense is used when some action is continuing at the time of speaking, when some action is going on, something is going on at the time of speaking or at the present time. So if I say I am reading a book, this means I am reading a book at the present time, at the time of speaking. But if I say I read a book during my leisure hours, I am talking about something that I do usually but I am not doing at the present time. I read a book in my leisure hours. This means when I am free, I read a book. But when I say I am reading a book, I mean this action is going on at the present time. I am reading this book at the present time. I am riding a bicycle. That means I am riding a bicycle right now. This action is taking place, continuing right now. But when I say I ride a bicycle in the morning, here I am using simple present tense to express something that I habitually do or do as a matter of routine. So we have to discriminate between the use of simple present and the use of present continuous tense. That is, simple present is used for habitual action, routine action, etc., whereas present continuous is used for some action which is going on at the time of speaking, which is taking place at the time of speaking. Now there are certain verbs in English which are not used in the progressive tense. They are usually avoided in the progressive tense, that is continuous tense. These verbs are verbs of perception. like, see, know, desire, love, hate, like, seem, feel, and verbs of possession like belong, own, have, etc. They are generally not used in the continuous form. As per the conventions of English speakers, they are avoided. The use of these verbs are avoided, is avoided in the form of, in continuous form. So they have to be mostly used in simple present form, unless there is a situation where they have to be used in the continuous form. So I will give an example of some of these verbs, how they are used in the simple present form rather than continuous form. As a matter of rule, one has to avoid the use of such verbs in progressive form, continuous form. Now, verbs of feeling, like, I like him, I love him. Now, if you say, I am loving him, or I am liking him, I am knowing him, I am understanding him. So these are not appropriate uses of such English verbs. Rather, you have to say, I know him, I love him, I like him, I understand him. Again, verbs of possession, like belong, own, and have. So, I am having a house. Rather than this, you have to say, I have a house. I have four children. You have to avoid saying, I am having four children. I own a house. This is okay, but you say, I am owning a house, you are using continuous tense. So continuous tense has to be avoided when it comes to verbs of feeling, perception, and possession, etc. Now, continuous tense, let us learn the use of continuous tense in other situations. Continuous tense is used to describe some action which is taking place at the time of speaking. I am riding a bicycle. Now, if you say, I am riding a bicycle, that means you are riding a bicycle at the present time. You are riding a bicycle at the time of speaking. If you say, I am taking tea, that means you are taking tea at the time of speaking, at the present time. That is, the action continues at the present time. Now, if you say, I take tea, that will indicate a different meaning. That will mean you take tea every day, or you take tea by matter of habit. It won't mean you are taking tea at the present time. So if you have to express this action continuing at the present time, you have to use present continuous tense, saying, I am taking tea. That is enough to indicate that you are taking tea at the present time. So present continuous tense, in all cases, used to express an action taking place in the present time. Again, present continuous tense is also used to indicate some action taking place in near future. I am meeting the minister tomorrow. Now here, this action will take place in future, but you are using present continuous tense. Now, present continuous tense you are using here for a planned action in future, which is going to take place in future. So here you see how present continuous tense is used to indicate an action in future time. I am seeing my friend in the evening. I am seeing my friend in the evening. Here seeing actually means, though it's a verb of perception. Now, verb of perception I have just now told you are not used in present continuous tense. But here, this verb of perception, I am seeing him this evening, I am seeing my friend this evening. Here you are using it in a continuous form, because here this verb of perception is actually used for a different meaning. It is used for the sense of meeting rather than seeing. So it is no longer used as a verb of perception. It is used as a verb indicating meeting with somebody. So in such cases, there are exceptions like this, where verb of perfection may also be used for continuous, but this will always indicate an action planned in future time. Now, we have to be careful about a kind of mixing of these two tenses, that is simple present and present continuous. That is, we sometimes use present continuous where we have to use simple present, and we use simple present where we have to use present continuous. Now, let me give an example. I am going for a walk every day. Now, this sentence, here the verb use is in the present continuous form. Now, supposing that you are going for a walk every day. Of course, you are going for a walk every day, but because this is a habit or this is a routine, as per the conventions of usage of English verbs in simple present form, we have to use simple present tense here rather than continuous tense. So rather than saying, I am going for a walk every day, you have to say here better, I go for a walk every day. So anything that you do as a matter of habit or routine, you have to use simple present tense. I go for a walk every day, I take a cup of coffee every day, I read a newspaper in the morning. All these sentences are in the simple present form, because what you are, the action that you are indicating here is a habitual action or a routine action. But if you have to talk about something that you are doing at the present time, at the time of speaking, then you have to use present continuous tense. So this discrimination we have to make in the usage of these two tenses. Again, present continuous tense is also used for some planned action in future time, and simple present tense too may be used for some action planned in future time. Now from here, we move on to the use of perfect tense. Present perfect tense, perfective aspect of tense. Now this generally, in the present form, takes the auxiliary have or has. We use the auxiliary have or has, and when you use the auxiliary have or has, that is the helping verb have or has in the perfective form, then the main verb generally in the past participle form, that is the third form of the verb. So it is used for some action that is completed but is still continuing. I have been reading a book. Now here, this is present perfect continuous tense. Here the action is started in the past, but is continuing till the present. I have taken my breakfast. Now this is a sentence in the present perfect tense. I have taken my breath. But now you see here that as soon as you use the auxiliary have, the verb is converted into the third form, past participle form. I have taken. You cannot say I took, I have took. So compulsorily you have to use the past participle form in the perspective as the main verb, whereas you have to use the perfective aspect tense, that is have or has, in this kind of sentence. Now here you have to use this kind of tense to indicate that some action is completed. I have seen the Taj Mahal. In a sentence like this, when you use this simple perfect tense, that means you have already seen the Taj Mahal. Again, I have done my BA. That means you have completed your graduation. Again, this tense, present perfect tense, is learned in relation to use of simple past tense. Unless you keep in mind the use of simple past tense, you cannot completely learn the use of present perfect tense, because it's always related to past some action completed. Now when you use past tense, again we are talking of some action completed. When you say I have done my BA, that means you have finished your BA. When you say I did my BA, that also means you have completed your BA. Then there is a confusion as to where one has to use perfect tense, simple perfect, present perfect tense and simple past tense. So there is a clear indication for this, there is a clear suggestion for this. That is, when there is a past time adverb or a past time indicator like yesterday, last night, last year, etc., then you have to compulsorily use simple past tense. That is, if you have to say, I did my BA last year, you have to compulsorily use past tense, simple past tense. So, whenever there is a last part past time indicator like yesterday, last night, last year, you have to use simple past tense for an action completed. When there is no such indicator, you have to use present perfect tense rather than simple past tense. Let us talk about present perfect continuous tense. Present perfect continuous tense is used when some action is started in the past but has not been completed. It is still continuing. If one say, I have been speaking for an hour, now have been speaking, the continuous form in the perfective aspect, have been speaking, then it means some action is started in the past but is still continuing. He has been ailing for a long time. So again, as something that is started in the past is still continuing. I have been living in this house for a long time. This means you started living in this house in the past and are still living in this house. If we say, I have lived in this house for a long time, the meaning will change. This will mean you are no longer living in this house. So again, we have to discriminate between present perfect continuous and simple past, because the meaning will change with your grammatical expression. I have been living in this house for a long time. This means you started living in this house in the past and is still living in that house. If you say, I have lived in this house for a long time, that means you are talking about some house in which you are no longer living. So this is a very subtle difference in meaning, and it occurs with the change of tense. Now, talking about present perfect continuous tense, we have to further emphasize that this tense is used when some action is started in the past and is still continuing. I have been reading this novel for a month. I have been working on this project for quite some time. In these cases, you are using present continuous tense because you are talking about some action which is started in the past and is still continuous. Now with this, let me give you some exercises, the keys to which will be provided at the beginning of the next lesson. So these exercises will enable you to test and judge what you have learned so far. To these exercises will be provided to you the beginning of the next lesson. If you have any queries, questions pertaining to this lesson, then you can make your inquiries on the following address: Directorate Distance Education, Maulana Azad National Urdu University, Kachi Bauli, Hyderabad 500032. Thank you, learners, for your patient listening and participation in this program. Goodbye and good luck.